everybody want? An incredible leap by Rikishi, who would be the Intercontinental Champion right now if not for that thumb tag.
The bowling contest is scheduled for one fall. Entering the ring from Lima, Ohio, weighing 245 pounds.
Well, even you couldn't figure out why Taz was doing all these interference and run-ins. Maybe that's just part of Taz's thug life philosophy.
Well, I think that is just a cheap excuse for poor behavior. And if it wasn't for Taz right now, Rikishi would be the Intercontinental Champion. He should be. And the issue between Taz and Rikishi is far from over. Capping off what has been a fully loaded week here in the World Wrestling Federation. But the next 7 days are going to be wild. And the week begins, of course, with Raw is War. Live this Monday from the Georgia Dome. The house is going to be rocking. It's going to be a raucous night in Atlanta. And we want you to be part of the event. Call the number on your screen right now to get tickets for the Georgia Dome. This Monday night, Raw is War, live in Atlanta. Tickets for World Wrestling Federation events, Tom, move so fast. This is an opportunity for fans to be part of the huge event live this Monday in Atlanta.
You want to get your tickets while you can, Kevin. The Georgia Dome will be rocking, that's for sure. All the superstars, including The Rock and Chris Benoit, will be on hand.
The new alliance formed between Shane McMahon, Chris Benoit, Kurt Angle, and The Big Show. They, of course, will be there, and it's going to be a huge night. Al Snow, Lariat collar and elbow with Gangrel. Two very evenly matched superstars. Gangrel, hard right hand in the midsection. Al Snow turns it around, a series of his own. You want to talk about two evenly matched superstars. How about Triple H and Y2J Chris Jericho? What a war that last man standing match was.
Wow, unbelievable. Again, then we saw the mutual respect between both superstars the next night on Raw, but it ended with a confrontation backstage between Triple H and Y2J. Obviously, that mutual respect ended as quickly as it started.
A lot of stems and petals all over the McMahon-Helmsley office as Y2J and Triple H battled. But of course, the flowers were strewn about thanks to some real emotion that's being exchanged between Triple H and his wife, Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley.
Oh, man, I don't think it helped Triple H's cause too much when Stephanie walked in on the game, actually showing Trish just a move and a counter. Obviously on SmackDown, that didn't sit too well.
Yeah, even, of course, the Forest Nightmare on Raw happened again on SmackDown. Another office full of flowers destroyed, this time courtesy of Stephanie, as the wife scorned as she caught Triple H and Trish in a rather awkward moment, I guess we could say.
Well, come on. I mean, Stephanie trying to do something nice for Triple H. The game doesn't need flowers to feel good about himself or feel good about the marriage. I'm just trying to help Trish out in the ring because having to be in an intergender tag match, thanks to the commissioner, Triple H didn't want to go in there totally by himself.
Well, wait a minute now. Of course, the night began on SmackDown with Triple H trying to kiss up to his wife and got her a whole ton of flowers. From there, the announcement by Mick Foley that Triple H would have to team with Trish against Y2J and Lita. And the disparaging comments that Triple H made about women in general, Stephanie included, didn't sit well with his wife. And then from there, the compromising position, Triple H better learn being married is a full-time job and cover in a near fall.
Yeah, full-time job. Stephanie can't take the truth. Maybe she ought to reconsider.
Well, of course, we know that there was a lot of emotion exchange throughout this past week between Triple H and his wife, Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley. But it was a very good week for Stephanie's brother, Shane McMahon, who shocked us all by bringing the Big Show back to the World Wrestling Federation on his side. It was the Big Show who was put out by Shane 2 months ago.
And obviously, Kurt Angle and Shane McMahon got together and co-conspired with the Big Show to work on getting The Undertaker out of action, and it so happened on Raw, and it happened very well.
It certainly did, although bad results for The Undertaker. Modified slam there and a near fall on Gangrel. We will show you the highlights of how The Undertaker was taken apart by Shane McMahon and company, as well as we'll talk more about what happened to Y2J Chris Jericho at the hands of Shane and Chris Benoit last Thursday on SmackDown. But we can tell you that when all was said and done, both The Undertaker and Chris Jericho will now spend time on the injured list, courtesy of Shane McMahon, Chris Benoit, The Big Show, and Kurt Angle.
Yeah, Jericho didn't have a very good week.
The war, the high moment, the high water mark of Jericho's career, the fully loaded last man standing match against Triple H, now just a distant memory. Gangrel going for the Impaler, Al Snow with the counter. And now, Dragon Sleeper, he's got it locked in.
Oh, wow, what a tap out. Bring the bell.
Al Snow shows a variety of offense and gets the win against Gangrel. A light heavyweight title defense for Dean Malenko later on in